In this video, I will demonstrate how to create and apply common filters in SAS Visual Analytics. Let's take a look at the SAS documentation definition of a common filter. It is a filter that can be shared between objects in a report. When the common filter is edited, the filter is updated everywhere it is used. The common filter cannot be shared between reports. Now let's clearly identify the benefits. It is easy to apply the same filter conditions to multiple objects in a report. It is a hot edit, which means any changes or updates to the filter condition will be applied to every use of the filter. And the common filter is available for the entire report across multiple pages. And now for the limitations. The objects must share the same data source as the common filter definition, and the common filter is not available across multiple reports. Let's get started with the demonstration. I will be using SAS Visual Analytics 8.5 for the hands-on portion of this video, but the same technique can be used in earlier releases, specifically anything SAS Visual Analytics 8.3 and later. We will start with the pre-built report, as filters are typically applied to objects after you have already assigned their roles. On the first page of the report, named Last 30 Days, we will create a filter to return the last 30 days for a line chart, and then convert this to a common filter and apply that common filter to the tree map object. First, we must select the line chart to activate it. Then we'll open the Filters pane, and we'll click on New Filter and select Advanced Filter. Now we will use some built-in filter conditions offered in SAS Visual Analytics. Since we are going to base this on last 30 days, we will need a date data item. First, expand the date grouping, and then we will select day. The automatic conditions that come with SAS Visual Analytics are listed here in the conditions section. We are going to scroll until we see last 30 days. To add it to our expression builder, we will double-click on it. Everything is already done for us. Now we just need to give this filter a meaningful name, and we can look at the number of returned observation versus total observations to verify that the filter is working. Click OK. Now we can see that the line chart's values are subsetted. Let's be sure to tell our report consumers what they are looking at by giving this object a meaningful title. Now we need to convert this filter to a common filter. With the line chart still activated, let's go over to our Filters pane, use the Overflow menu for the Last 30 Days filter, and select Change to Common Filter. If we move over to the Data pane, we can see that the common filter is added. Down at the bottom for this data source, where we can see that it is tied to the particular data source, the common filter grouping has Last 30 Days. Now we can apply this common filter to the tree map object. Now we need to activate the tree map by clicking on it. Using the Filter pane, go over to New Filter, and now here is our Last 30 Days common filter which we can select. Now that this has been applied, let's add to our title so that it's meaningful and people know that we're only looking at the last 30 days of activity. Let's move on to the second example of this report. On the second page, Parameterized Character, I will define a parameter-driven common filter. Let's start with looking at the role assignments. I have already assigned the roles for each of the objects we are looking at. First, in the drop-down list, we can see I have year. Second, for the text input, we can see that I have already defined a parameter named text input parameter to hold the value of any entered text. Then we have our role assignments for the bar chart, as well as for the list table. The aim of this page is to take the value entered in the text input window and build a filter expression to only return data rows which contain that entered text, and then apply that filter condition to both the bar chart and the list table. What we're going to do is select and activate the bar chart, and now we're going to build our parameter-driven filter expression. Over on the Filter tab, we're going to select New Filter and Advanced Filter. We are going to build a filter expression to determine if the product description data item contains the entered text stored in our text input parameter. We are going to use the built-in SAS Visual Analytics conditions again. First, we will expand the character grouping and look for product description. When we select on product description, we'll get automatic conditions down below. We are going to use the contains condition. Go ahead and double-click on it to add it to the expression builder. Next, we need to go down and expand the parameter grouping and we will drag and drop our text input parameter to the second half of the contained statement. Now we need to wrap each side of the expression in either an upcase or lowercase function so that mixed case is ignored. To do this, we're going to switch to the operators tab. We're going to go to text simple, and I'm going to use the upcase function. When I drag and drop it, I want to hover over not the entire thing, but first we're going to upcase the product description, and we're going to see if it contains the upcase of the text input parameter. Remember, whichever you choose, it has to be the same on both sides of the expression. Lastly, let's give our filter a meaningful name. Right now, the returned observations do not show any change because I have not entered any text into the text input parameter field. We can go ahead and click OK. Let's go ahead and convert this object level filter to a common filter. With the bar chart still active, on the filter pane, we're going to use the overflow menu for our text input contains filter. From the overflow menu, we'll say change to common filter, and we can verify that it was added to common filter on the data pane. Now we can apply it to the list table. Let's go ahead and select the list table object. From the filter pane, we'll say new filter, and we'll select our text input contains filter. Now let's go ahead and test the filter. Here I'm going to type red, and we can see that both the bar chart and the list table update. We can see the products that contain red. Here we can even see for thoroughbred, we see red at the end for the contains, as well as short-haired, R-E-D down there. Now this helps if you know your data. I know I have some female-based products, so I want to see how those are doing. We can see for police, go ahead and filter this based on profit. Ooh, both aren't doing very well, but that tennis athlete is doing better. And then we can check the male counterparts. Not for that one. Try this again. And here we can see the golf male athlete tends to be doing better here. Let's go ahead and move on to our third example. That's on the from to week page. And we are going to create another parameter-driven common filter. Like before, let's walk through my objects and my role assignments. For both drop-downs, we can see from the role pane, I have the year-week category, and then I have a parameter created to save those values selected. The from is going to be stored in the from week parameter, and the to the 2-week parameter. So these are going to give us our boundaries. We can see that it's not in the report or page prompt area, so these are not going to automatically filter anything. Their values instead will be saved straight into these parameters. For my key value object, we can see that I'm returning the measure profit. And then for my waterfall chart, we can see I have year, week, and profit. Let's go ahead and start by defining the filter expression for the waterfall object. With our waterfall object active, we are going to use our filters pane, select new filter, advanced filter to bring up our filter expression builder. Now we need to build our parameter-driven filter expression. In this filter, I will subset the year, week, date values, which are inclusively between what I'm prompting. I'm prompting the from and the to boundaries. Let's go ahead and expand the date grouping because we're going to go ahead and use those built-in SAS Visual Analytics conditions that it gives us. We're prompting for year, week, and then we're going to look for between inclusive. Double click it to add it to our expression builder. And now I just need to drag and drop our parameters that hold those year, week boundaries. Scroll down to the parameter grouping, expand that, drag our from week parameter to the top boundary, our 2-week parameter to the bottom boundary. We can see that the number of observations are being subsetted, and now I need to give this filter expression a meaningful name and click OK. Let's go ahead and see if everything is updating correctly. If I click here to here, we can see that from 20 week 7 to 20 week 14 is being displayed. Now let's convert this to a common filter. Activate the waterfall chart. From the filter pane, we are going to use the overflow menu from the from to week filter and say change to common filter. We can see that it is added in the data pane down here under the common filter grouping. Now we can add this to the key value object. select the key value object to activate it. From the filter pane, use the new filter and select from to weak filter. Lastly, I want to demonstrate how we can apply all three of these common filters on a completely different page. The fourth page of this report, named Profit Dashboard, I will show you how you can apply these common filters to objects on a different page from which they're created. Remember, they only need to share the same data source. I also chose different report objects to further demonstrate how common filters can be used across not only pages, but also different objects and still be effective. Let's take a look at the text object. We can see the text object has static text and a measure. On the roles pane, we can see that I've added profit to return along with the static text. I'm going to add the last 30 days common filter to this. So that last 30 days of profit, so the profit measure will be reflected accurately. So with the text object active, I'm going to use the filter pane, add my new filter for last 30 days. And we can see how that is different from the total sum. I want it to also be reflected in this list table. So we can see that my list table roles have day and profit. I'm going to use the filter pane and also represent the last 30 days. And we can see that both those sums match. For the word cloud object, I'm going to apply the text input contains filter. With the word cloud active and on the filter pane, I'm going to say new filter, and I'm going to do text input contains filter. The last thing I had entered in that, which the parameter is storing, is the mail. So here I can see which product description, which product has the most and highest profit based on the size of the word cloud. Lastly, for the bar chart, we're going to use our from to weak filter. Remember, these values are coming from the selected values that were on the third page. With the bar chart active, from the filter pane, I'm going to say new, click on the new filter, and click on the from to weak filter. Now you have seen how that once a common filter is defined, it can be used for any object in the same report that uses the same data source. For more information, please refer to the SAS Visual Analytics documentation or check out one of my other blogs or videos. Thank you, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.